Oh, what up? Sure, 3 a.m. Why not? So, yeah, dude. Yeah, I agree, bro. This is one of those things that's, like for me, how do I say this? This is very much like the Bible, bro. Like, there's some truth in it. You know, positive thinking, living as if you are what you want to be type thing. I guess that would be like fake it till you make it. These kind of ideas. Like, there are psychological benefits to some of these things, especially short term. It's definitely a very good way to, break out of a negative cycle or pattern. So, I try not to push back too much when people talk about these sort of things, but because I just take the attitude, what works for other people, for lack of a better term here, other people's truths. I'm not here to discredit what other people attribute certain things to. But in the grand scheme, or as a, I love that they call this a law, like the law of attraction. Like, what the, who decided it was a law? Like, in what context are we using this word law? You know what I mean? Because I don't think it's a fucking law, to be honest. I just, sometimes I wonder about people, like these theories that we have about life, much like science, they're supposed to be continually tested. Tentative upon new discoveries, quote unquote. Science, how science is supposed to work. Trust the science. Okay. If I was to say I spent 20 years trying to attract a better fucking job, a relationship with, whether it be a fucking girlfriend or at this point, stable motherfucking friendships, or not just stable, but I don't know, even reliable, consistent. It's led me to a lot of my frustrations, meaning that I made honest efforts in a lot of things over certain periods of time. And I was fully bought in, fully invested. And when I look at the results of that, again, like I spoke on the other night, it don't hold up scrutiny. And this is just another one, bro. Like manifestation, people talk about. Oh, you just gotta manifest it, bro. You just gotta manifest. I'm sorry, what, bro? Like, I do believe that intention is very important. But it's important for yourself. I think in terms of like maintaining just simple positive mental health, even healthiness, being a good intentioned person goes a long way with that. But if you look at the world around us and the way a lot of people have moved and operated, especially over the past 4 years, would you say, of people who were negatively affected, they manifested that? Would you say the people that are perpetrating this, manifested that based on good intentions? No, we could say, you know, there's a light and a dark side. There's dark magic, and then these people are all dealing in dark magic, you know, manipulating people. And we call that magic now. We call lying magic. And I guess, I don't know, is it? Is it? Let me ask, is it? It certainly has a magical effect on people, doesn't it? You tell people what they want to hear. Magically, they treat you very well, don't they? You tell people the truth, or you tell people something that's not in their own wheelhouse or agenda. Well, you know, they'll diss on you, no matter how good your intentions are. Et cetera, et cetera. So if I'm a good intention person and I'm attracting negativity, or phoniness, am I to assume I'm being phony too? I don't know. I don't know. Let me think about that. Am I really a, quote, nice person that does support and generally wants everybody to succeed and be happy and, you know, have all their best dreams and wishes fulfilled? Well, if I say yes, then the law of attraction is total bullshit, like the title here says. Or, I don't know, is there a law of opposites? Because that's what I feel like. I feel like I live in an upside down world. I feel like the only way to get ahead is to cheat and, you know, take advantage of someone else in some sort of way. Because you know why? The people around me who've taken advantage of me, that's what they got out of it. Gains. You know what I mean? And I'm the one left holding the fucking bag going, did I manifest this? You know, I hate to, you know, be, quote, negative here. But I don't know. What if I was just completely fucking negative? Would the results be any better or worse? Like, what more could I fucking attract here? For better or for worse? I'm certainly not attracting better. I got less friends, less family, less money, less opportunities, less hope, less avenues for even just real world based roads of self, like if you want to do something honest and with good intentions, would you say there's more or less support for that nowadays? And, you know, support is not the best word. Not necessarily that someone has to support my ideas. But there's certainly more people working against them. Or not necessarily people even, but circumstances, realities. So what do we attribute that to? Some fucking, inner dialogue that's not happening, taking place. And again, I'm gonna go to the greatest example I know, bro. These fucking religious people, these Bible thumping motherfuckers, bro. They got the fucking good news, the good book, the good word, bro. They've had it for 2,000 fucking years. Where the fuck are we at right now? Well, you know, that's because everybody turned away from God. Yeah, including y'all motherfuckers. Like, if it's all about manifestation, if it's all about law of attraction, if it's all about God's will, why does a fucking preacher man need your fucking money? Don't you think if they were really doing God's work, God would take care of that shit? Now, this is this topic is not, it's not an absolute for me. But this idea of a law, quote unquote, of attraction, is really bothersome. It's a fucking theory. It's not a fucking law. Now, you know, if you want to attract negative consequences, sure, go put yourself in situations where the probability of a negative outcome is, you know, statistically significant. I'll give you another example. You know, a lot of people like to say if you, if you want to move up in the world, if you want to better, you know, you got to better yourself. You got to fucking do this. You got to do that. You got to fucking, you work hard. It pays off. If you never give up, you're going to be rewarded. Blah, blah, blah. All this shit. You know who says these motherfucking tropes? These people that we call successful enough who are put forth as the spokespeople for success. But, you know, I don't know. We'll call it a career field. My career field is music, right? So, in the music industry, the only way for me to really get paid is, you know, to make it an actual career. Well, to get a record deal, what I gotta do, bro? I gotta bend the fuck over. It don't matter how fucking talented you are. You're gonna bend over. Well, I'm not even going to ask that rhetorically. There's plenty of examples of talented people getting to a certain point where all their hard work was about to pay off. And they chose not to bend over. And you know what? Those people are not successful, are they? They're not giving interviews, telling other people how to live their fucking dreams, are they? No more so than, you know, people who, I don't know, here's another one. How about marriage, bro? How many people at one point in time in their life say they found the one, the one, get married, and it's just fucking perfect wedding bliss all throughout? Would you say the majority? Well, even if you want to say half, 50-50. 50-50? What is that, like flipping a fucking coin, bro? Does that make something a law? No matter how sure of yourself you are in a moment about it? How many people you know, at least at one point in their life, had a, quote, good job, and then at another point, don't? When they had the good job, they thought they were I don't know. What? You think you're where you're supposed to be. You think you earned it. Until what? Until you're just a fucking worthless piece of shit again. Like, I guess the running through, I've been having a couple of days here of critical analysis of a lot of shit randomly. And there seems to be this theme. And you know, and trying to phrase this in a way that doesn't sound completely contradictory, but okay, I know how to say it. Sure, you might see this as all negative, what's coming out of my mouth. Quote, negative. But, it's the truth. And I'll extend that to what's definitely my truth, quote unquote, based on my little, experiment of life here. And somebody else will say, well, that's not my truth. My truth is law of attraction works. Okay. And I'm going to tell you like I tell everybody. I've been saying this for decades. Okay. We'll see in 5 and 10 years how true that shit is. Because not very many people are living a fairy tale life, especially nowadays. And if you are, God bless you. But I'm going to say this, enjoy it while it lasts. Because here's a fucking law. Nothing in life is guaranteed, is it? So what exactly is a fucking law? Anyway. Well, it's just shit you tell yourself. And there's nothing wrong with that. A little self-psychology. Psych yourself out. Pump yourself up. Be your biggest fan. Find your own motivations. For me, good intentions. Sticking to the truth. Trying to, you know, be of it. Be, you know, what I talk about. Like, keep it real, I guess. Like, to me, it's just psychologically healthy and easy than for me to be, you know, like a con artist or a preacher or, you know, any of that other horseshit. A hookup artist or anything, you know what I mean? Just for me personally, it's just the 3D rewards ain't shit. The 5D, the spiritual, the self-esteem, all that shit. Sure, yeah, it's helpful that way. But would I go around telling people this is a fucking law? No. Why? Because I'm aware that that would be gaslighting to a lot of people. People like my cousin that I've grown up with, same age as me. He's got a rare bone disease. He's in a wheelchair. His whole fucking life. Never walked. Got a great fucking attitude. Always been, hey, more positive than me. Even now, even though he has down days, you know, shit is very fucking dark for him, and I think about it all the time. Did he attract that? Did he agree to come into this fucking life? And be that a birth defect? Is that the law? When people say they want to eat fucking organic food, is that attracting GMO stabberoonies? mandated to everybody? Is that how this? That's the law of fucking opposites, or the reality of upside down world. How do we have a law of attraction in upside down world? Can we rectify that? Can we go deeper? Or should we just stay on the surface and say, you know, just plaster a fucking smile on your face. Never think about, you know, dark thoughts, dark realities. And we'll just let the truth be fucking fairy tales and unicorns. You know what I mean? Including that fucking bunk ass religion shit. It's got everybody hollowed out, disconnected, heartless ass motherfuckers who won't even stand up for kids. They're so fucking self-absorbed, self-centered. They forsake everything. For what? Attracted to some fucking Jesus that ain't coming back, bro. Some fucking fairy tale Santa Claus horseshit. So, you know, I'm not against, you know, people can believe whatever you got to believe to get through this life, bro. I've always been all for it. And, you know, for me, it's about keeping it real, bro. And maybe in the course of keeping it real, this law of attraction, I don't know, it's trying to prove to me that real is fake. Is that it? There's no value to real. Real is a fringe. Truth is a relative to social trends and, you know, mandates. You get my drift? So, sorry, this is a bummer, but you know, when the universe calls, and I feel attracted to oblige, I have to keep it real, bro. And now I'll just observe the results of that experiment. Because this kind of horseshit don't hold up to my scrutiny. But hey, you know, sometimes miraculous things do happen. Sometimes coincidences do play out. I give thanks to God, quote, universe, whatever. Whoever's responsible, I have gratitude for that. And I leave it at that. As a way of just being humble about it. Otherwise, I would just intellectualize it and say, well, subconsciously, that's what I wanted. And subconsciously, I trick myself into getting what I wanted anyway. Know what I mean? Because maybe I don't want these things. Maybe what I say I want, what I think I want, is really just bullshit, right? Because that's obviously what I'm attracting around here. A whole lot of bullshit. What about you? How's How's fucking life on your fucking corner of the globe? Fairy tales and unicorns? God bless you. Life coach. Which is funny, you know. It's really like the only the only viable market for my horseshit skills. Applicable to who? Nobody. Myself. Huh. I'm the only person I'm coaching. Because everybody else is just talking a bunch of bullshit. All right.